गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, माई सेल्फ नेम पी एस तिवारी फ्रॉम एल पी सवानी विद्या भवन। वी विल कंटिन्यू विद द सब्जेक्ट ओसी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन ऑफ कॉमर्स। लेट्स स्टार्ट। यस चिल्ड्रन, इन लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव डन टिल सेकेंड चैप्टर। नाउ टुडे विल स्टार्ट विद द थर्ड चैप्टर, दैट इज बिजनेस सर्विसेज टू। विल कवर इंट्रोडक्शन, मीनिंग एंड फंक्शन। इंट्रोडक्शन, मीनिंग एंड फंक्शन। ओके, हेयर द इंट्रोडक्शन अबाउट द बिजनेस सर्विसेज इज इम्पॉर्टेंस ऑफ कॉमर्स इज इंक्रीजिंग इन प्रेजेंट टाइम। इन कॉमर्स अपार्ट फ्रॉम ट्रेड, बैंकिंग इज कंसिडर्ड एज इट्स ऑक्सिलरी सर्विसेज। एज वी नो दैट कि बैंकिंग वी आर प्रोवाइडिंग एज अ एडिशनल सर्विसेज। बैंकिंग इंडस्ट्री इज वेरी यूजफुल टू इंडस्ट्रीज, एग्रीकल्चर एंड अदर फील्ड इन एडिशन टू ट्रेड। सिमिलरली द इंस्टीट्यूट विच प्रोवाइडिंग द सर्विसेज ऑफ बैंकिंग इज कॉल्ड बैंक। दिस पॉइंट यू कैन अंडरलाइन, द इंस्टीट्यूट प्रोवाइडिंग सर्विसेज ऑफ बैंकिंग इज कॉल्ड बैंक। द फर्स्ट बैंक ऑफ द वर्ल्ड स्टार्टेड इन जिनेवा इन द ईयर ऑफ 1407। द वर्ड बैंक इज डराइव फ्रॉम द इटालियन वर्ड बैंको। The evidence of activity of the bank are also found in the ancient time. This word emerged in the Roman Empire, where the money lender known as Massella. They are supposed to establish a small temporary shop on a long bench, that is called bensu, within a close fence. The word bensu and bank have been derived from this. This will ask for your one word answer or may for MCQ also. Fine. The institute providing services of banking is called bank. First bank, the world started in Geneva in the year of 1407. The bank is derived from the Italian word, that is banco. In Roman Empire, the money lender, those who are lending the money to the borrower, the money lender is supposed to call Massella, and they are supposed to use a small temporary shop on a long bench to provide loan to the needy people, and that particular thing is called bensu. Now we'll start with the meaning. See children, meaning is, according to the Reserve Bank of India, bank is an institute which collects deposit in order to lend them with condition to return it at the end of the fixed term or whenever it is demanded. Two meaning is given in your syllabus according to your textual content. The second one is, the institute providing services of banking is called bank. It is my personal opinion, kindly refer the second one, because this is the easiest one and it will be useful for the further study also, not only for 11th standard, whether you are supposed to giving banking exam, etc. So you can use this definition as well. The institution providing services of banking is called bank. Now children, let's move to the function. In page number 22, you can see that functions 1 and 2. First is to accept a deposit, and apart from this services, bank performs the other activity too. That is, second one, to invest or lend money. To accept a deposit is the first function. And second one, to invest or lend money to the needy people. But in the present time, a bank does other function too. Apart from these, banking services has been developed very well, and variety is found in its services too. There is an immense growth in the services offered by the bank, and the focus is on customers. It is difficult to make a list of all function of bank, because function of bank can be divided into two parts, main function and subsidiary function. Fine. So many work has been done by the banking sector, but according to the understanding part, it is bifurcated in two different categories. First is main function, second is subsidiary function. Let's start with the same. Now see children, this table, main function and subsidiary function, you can see the main function of the bank are to accept and collect deposit, second to lend money, third to invest money, fourth to do interbanking transaction. In your exam, if you are supposed to ask the query, write down the function of bank. So in your reference book or digest, only main function reflected. But it is compulsion for 5 marks. You have to write down both these function, main as well as subsidiary. Here are the subsidiary function. First one, to look after the financial transaction of the customer, to take care of the financial transaction. Second, to do transaction of foreign exchange. Third, to issue letter of credit. Fourth, to issue traveler's check. Fifth, to provide draft services. Sixth, to provide information related to credit of the person which is associated with the bank. Seventh one, to provide services as an underwriter. And last is to provide other related services such as ATM, DMAT, safe deposit vault, etc. So these are the functions of bank. Main functions as well as subsidiary function. Let's discuss this in detail. See, first of all, we'll discuss the main function of bank. The first one is to accept the deposit. Fine, bank accepts some surplus amount as a deposit and bank can pay the interest to the deposit holder. Fine, when you are submitting or depositing amount in the bank, in return, bank will pay the interest to the account holder, those who are depositing the amount in the bank. The biggest responsibility of the bank is to maintain trust of the deposit holder or the customer who invests money in the bank. Bank accepts various type of deposit as per the different rate of interest. Fine. For accepting deposit, bank has given a types of account. In this type of account, the investor or depositor can deposit the amount. And according to the same, bank will provide them rate of interest in return. Mainly, four types of deposits are there. First, saving account. Second, current account. Third, recurring account. Fourth, fixed term account. Children, these four type of account are used for the depositing amount in the bank. And all these accounts are providing different services to the deposit holder in form of rate of interest. Different type of rate of interest paid by the bank to the account holder. Fine. Then the second one is to lend money. Bank accept deposit through different account, as we have discussed in the above passage, that bank are accepting the amount from the different accounts. Saving, current, recurring, fixed, etc. Thus, the bank lends money to the borrower, which it has to collect it as a deposit from different account. Short and simple, when bank accepts money, bank will pay interest to account holder. From where they will earn? They will provide that money to the borrower, to the needy people. And in return, bank will ask for the interest. Bank accept deposit and provide interest to the deposit holder. The bank lends money. When they are lending money to the needy people, at this stage, higher rate are charging by the bank. And when they are paying to the deposit holder, they are paying less rate of interest. The bank gains profit from the difference in the rate of interest. The bank lends money as per given below. हाउ दे आर सपोज टू लैंड मनी, यू कैन सी टू टाइप्स हाउ दे आर लैंडिंग द मनी, थ्रू अ लोन और बाय ओडी एंड सीसी. लोन, लोन दैट मीन्स इन प्रेजेंट टाइम होम लोन, कार लोन, एजुकेशन लोन, कैश क्रेडिट, मशीन लोन, गोल्ड लोन, पर्सनल लोन एक्सेट्रा आर अवेलेबल. बाय दिस वे बैंक कैन लैंड मनी टू द नीडी पीपल एंड इन रिटर्न बैंक विल आस्क फॉर रेट ऑफ इंटरेस्ट. देन सेकेंड फेज इज बाय ओडी एंड सीसी. मोस्ट प्रोबेबली दिस सर्विसेज इज प्रोवाइडिंग टू द करंट अकाउंट होल्डर, दैट मीन्स टू द बिजनेसमैन. करंट अकाउंट होल्डर आर गेटिंग दिस सर्विसेज ओडी एंड सीसी, दैट इज ओवरड्राफ्ट एंड सीसी. फाइन. नाउ थर्ड वन, टू इन्वेस्ट. द बैंक कैनॉट गेट बेनिफिट इफ इट इज नॉट एबल टू इन्वेस्ट एंड लैंड द अमाउंट ऑफ द कैपिटल एंड डिपॉजिट ऑफ द बैंक. An important work of bank is to invest this amount at some secure place and with proper calculation. The deposit holder, those who are depositing in the bank, they will get interest in return. How bank will pay to them? After investing somewhere, they will earn and partially according to the decided percentage they will pay to the account holder. The bank has to invest some percentage of total deposit in the government security. See, this is the important point. Bank has to invest some percentage of total deposit in the government security according to the rules of RBI. It's the rules of RBI. All kind of bank, whether they are private or public sector, doesn't matter. Compulsorily, they have to invest some percentage of total deposit in the government security on which the rate of interest is low. On which the rate of interest is low. It is inevitable for a bank to get instant cash by withdrawing investment during emergency or some accidental situation. A bank majorly invests in government security or in other financial capable unit. Fine. Here, it is unavoidable. Bank are not supposed to avoid. Plus, in case of emergency situation, accidental situation, you can use that particular government security. It will help you at the time of need. Then let's move towards the fourth point. See, here is the fourth point for main function, that is to do interbanking transaction. One of the main function of the bank is interbanking transaction. Every bank sometime faces shortage of money for a very short duration of a time, even less than 24 hours. Sometime it can happen customer or account holder are asking for the amount and the amount is not available in the bank. So at that particular situation, what bank will do? At this time, unused money in the bank is provided to the needy bank. Fine. That means suppose Yes Bank is having unused money and Axis Bank is needy bank. Fine. So at that particular stage, the arrangement is made by an agency which is appointed by the central bank, that is RBI. RBI will arrange one of the agency. In this way, the process of lending and borrowing money is completed through the central bank. The lender or the borrower does not come into direct contact with each other. Axis Bank will not come to direct contact with Yes Bank. They will contact to the agency and agency will do the necessary arrangement to the needy bank to provide services. The problem of the bank for the particular time is solved. At this stage, the problem can be solved with the help of appointed agency. When the bank gets the demanded amount instantly, that is called call money. Axis Bank got the emergency amount at the time of need. That instant demanded money is called call money. The interest has to be paid on received amount, whatever Axis Bank received from Yes Bank. They have to pay interest for the same on the basis of demanding and supply of money. And that interest, that rate of interest is called call money rate. The emergency amount calling by the needy bank at the time of emergency, the needy bank are asking for or demanding for amount, instant amount, that is called call money. And on call money, they have to pay the interest, and that interest is called call money rate. So children, today we have covered introduction, meaning, functions, bifurcation of the function, that is main function, subsidiary function. And we have discussed in deep the main functions only. Fine. In next lecture, we'll continue with the subsidiary function of bank. Till the time, you can revise all the content. And in next session, we'll continue with the subsidiary function of bank. Thank you for the day, children. Have a great day. Bye-bye.